arrange the classroom so you guys can just come in and go in and find a seat. There should be plenty of seats.
A number of high-level visitors stopped by the Defense Language Institute Foreign Language Center June 30th to discuss the foreign language linguist training pipeline and lifelong learning opportunities that may increase proficiency scores and affect retention.
Sir, Dr. Savakinis, D.L.A. Provost. Good to meet you, sir.
Visitors had the opportunity to observe students in the classroom and see firsthand the intensity of instruction and the proficiency of students at various stages of their studies. The visit was led by Ronald Moultrie, the Undersecretary of Defense for Intelligence and Security, accompanied by Gilbert Cisneros, the Undersecretary of Defense for Personnel and Readiness.
With all of the things that we have, the billions of dollars of infrastructure that we have in place that allows us to identify targets, to collect on those targets, to actually process that information using the tremendous computing power that we have, it all culminated with someone taking the language and being able to turn that into intelligence or turn it into information that could be consumed by some leader within our government, by some military commander in the field, by the Secretary of Defense, or the person that we call customer number one, the President of the United States. And I can't tell you how many times language analysts have gone in who have graduated from this program to brief the President of the United States on things that we are doing around the world. Phenomenal, phenomenal. And for me, it was just, wow, these individuals are the ones who are making it happen. And it started in the same place that I started at. And today, for me to be the Undersecretary of Defense for Intelligence, I live it every day. I'm living it with the Russia-Ukraine conflict that's ongoing right now, living it as we look at this pivot to Asia and China and how we do this. I lived it through the years of really the heightened focus on the Middle East. And so all the languages that we have, from Russian to Mandarin to Arabic to Tagalog, you know, those things are all employed around the world every single day. Farsi, Korean, all of that helps us to do our mission.
Also joining him were Shawn Skelly, Assistant Secretary of Defense for Readiness, Mr. James Seacord, Director, Human Capital Management Office, and Brigadier General Terri Borras, Department of Army G2 Headquarters, Military Intelligence.
So I oversee human capital for the enterprise, both military and civilian, in terms of support to mission. Of course, in the intelligence mission, 97% of what we deal with is in a foreign language. So it is one of our highest priorities right now to ensure that we have both a military and civilian workforce that are capable of delivering foreign language skills to our intelligence mission across the board. I think the focus has been heavily on DLI itself. It's only one part of the solution, a very important part, but they can't do it themselves without a lot of help from others.
The leaders discussed looking beyond just the basic course for linguists. They focused on how to get to higher levels of proficiency with on-the-job experience, follow-on training, and better retention.
We're at a kind of inflection point of figuring out, is the requirement correct? Do we have the right governances in place to not only produce an incredible linguist, but also to deliver them to the force for the first time, but do we have the right mechanisms in place, the systems, the processes to manage them over the lifelong of their career? And then, and I think the second point of that, which has been really highlighted in all the discussions, is how do we retain, the rich, MOSs and expertise that we are creating.
One motivational element they talked about has already been put into practice, offering a Bachelor of Arts degree to further foreign language training upon reenlistment.
But I do want to thank DLI, FLC, for not only what it's doing today, but what it will do for us in the future. It's a national treasure. We got to continue to support it. We got to continue to polish the jewels on it, right? So that they continue to shine as brightly as they've shown for over 80 years. So thank you for all that, too.